Hello, I'm Andi, and I'm going to talk to you about a weekly horoscope from Sunday the 9th up to the 15th of September for you coming from Capricorn. It's raining very heavily outside, so you're getting that kind of noise coming in. Let's talk of Sunday the 9th, and what a fantastic morning and afternoon awaits you. Focus on what you want. These are planets that make you very determined. Some of them make you over-determined. Take the soft approach, but be focused on what you want and go for it. Is it the new romance? Is it the ongoing romance? Is it the marriage? Is it the job that you want improved? Is it the business that you want? Focus and go where you have to go, and you'll come back with a lot. Even if it's a Sunday, think business-wise, think job-wise, think how to make the betterment of your life, and you'll have every chance to show a lot for it on the morning, afternoon. But boy, your evening nightfall is going to be terrible, depressing and unhappy and changeable, and every planet can change as well, and the timetable will change. And tell yourself, evening nightfall, best of friendships can break, and a romance can be stretched to difficulties, and a marriage can be provoked to differences. So everything you do, take the middle path throughout the day. You got the fire in the morning, afternoon, so good for you. You got the water in the evening, nightfall, not good for you. So you got to mix and match slowly. And if you don't have to be out on the evening side, even better. That way your exposure is minimized. Stay at home. But when you go out, it could be anybody who walked by and all that, and you'll be very provoked. Monday the 10th, for you is not good. Too many ego planets there. They don't agree. Well, they agree with one of your planets to help you, give you the determination to get things done, fine. But they may make you very arrogant, and people may not like it. So be determined without showing any arrogance. Stay humble, stay friendly, stay supportive of others. And that way you may get something done in the morning, afternoon. But watch out, in the evening, nightfall is terrible. You will be dominating, you will be stubborn, you will be hot-tempered. And you will do all these things which will prove to be negative. And you will meet negative people as well. You will lower your self-esteem and your self-respect by being with people who make use of you in any way. Is it sexually? Is it mentally? Is it emotionally? Don't get down to that level on this evening nightfall period. Ask yourself, what am I doing here? So choose company very carefully in the evening nightfall period. And that way you can help yourself very much. Don't go out if I were you, because nothing much works. But if you have to go out, promises already made, tell yourself, I'm going to be very fussy and I'm going to stick to people that I can be proud of to be seen with. That's very important. It's a loser game for you in the evening nightfall period. Nothing much is going to happen. A lot of argument, a lot of quarrel, even accidents. Tuesday the 11th, morning and afternoon is no good. It's because you are not concentrating, because there are planets there very emotional. So are you thinking of the emotional problems or the emotional things you expect? Are you infatuated with somebody and, oh, you're thinking only of that? Well, watch out that your place at work or in your business areas, things could go very bad because your concentration level may not be there. And so you'll be making everything loused up. Things will go wrong. Blame will come. And if you're emotionally talking with anybody, it'll get worse. So don't go there. So focus on what you have to do in your job, in your business, and stick to it. Never mind two, three things. Do that one thing right at least, because you'll have difficulty to somehow focus, emotional problems. And you'll be very changeable as well. And people will not want to work with you because you're changing your mind all the time. And you'll be very timid and very oversensitive of who said what to you. So just put your head down, put your shoulder to the wheel and say, I'll have to finish this one commitment I have today, and then just finish it. Evening nightfall gets much better. Now you may find solutions in the evening nightfall to help you where you couldn't find in the earlier part of the day. And I like your evening nightfall because it's the planet of unexpected goodness. What more do you want? When we get expected goodness, is, oh, nice, I got it, but no excitement. But when it's unexpected goodness, maybe it's lotteries, you never know. So some unexpected goodness can happen with what you're doing on this Tuesday the 11th. Evening and nightfall period. So be out and about. Go out where you find the people are going to help you. Get in touch with people who can help you. Is it for the job? Is it for the business? Is it a new romance? Is it wanting to be just with nice people? And it's going to be a very exciting evening nightfall period. But one of these planets from the morning afternoon likes to be there, the spoiler. And you may meet somebody that you knew before that you don't like, and that could upset the whole card. So be careful. Walk away from that person. Wednesday the 12th for you coming from Capricorn is really a bad day, and it's a working day. You can lose a job. You can lose heavily in business, because your decision makings will be built on your stubbornness and your tendency to want things get done, because a planet will make you very dominating. So you don't want to be dominating, you don't want to be the leader, you want to look for advice from everybody, because what you do will be wrong. That's the program. What you do must go wrong. So why do it? Why not sit back? Let other people tackle it. Be the follower. Be part of the team, because blame also wants to come to you. So that's the only way to handle this. And if you don't want to do anything, would that be better? No. It means that you got nothing for nothing. So you got to work very hard on this morning and afternoon period to gain very little. But never mind, do that. I like your evening nightfall. You're going to be very, very rewarded. These now in the evening nightfall, in the morning afternoon, they are planets of no confidence, inferiority complexes. And so you feel that way. But the evening nightfall, you get all that courage back, and you can talk beautifully and you can do beautifully, because the correct planet comes to be with you and allows you that gift of communication and marketing skills especially, and creativity as well. Do everything you want to do. Wait for the evening nightfall period. If you're chasing for a date, don't try it earlier. Wait for the evening nightfall, make your call, and I tell you, you will get it. You try it in the morning, you will be coming back blue and black. You will feel very unhappy. You feel very dejected and rejected. And so I like your evening nightfall. Go out, have a purpose, have a plan, and you will get plenty in the evening nightfall period. Let's go to Thursday the 13th. At last, you've got 24 hours of good news coming your way. And these 24 hours, there are also planets of unexpected goodness. They're very powerful planets, these planets. They do make you a bit rebellious sometimes, but try and control that part of it. So you must go out to places where you can expect, is it the help you want in your job? Is it the help you want in your business? Is it what you're looking for, the romance? Is it to make your family and the people you love very happy? Go. Evening nightfall, go out in nice atmospheres. And again, these good planets, because these two planets of the morning afternoon are very close, and to the evening and nightfall planners, so they like to be together. So they make your evening nightfall even better. And you're going to shine in something, and whatever you're chasing for, you're going to get. So mix business and pleasure. Don't just go out to have a good time. That's waste. Tell yourself, I'm going to call people who can help me in my job. I want to be with people who can help me in my business. I want to meet that person I'm chasing for the romance, so let me call that group of people. I want to make my family very happy, so take them all out for a good dinner somewhere. And you will definitely, by the end of the evening is there, you say, I've maintained it and I've done very well and got more than an armful of good luck. Yes. Friday the 14th, a wonderful beginning. That simply means you're very lucky at your place of work. Good news will come. And that also means in business you would have touched the right buttons, and boy, there's all that reward and the good news. And so morning, afternoon, do very well in your communications, in your marketing sense. So communicate, ask favors, send out messages. Do it as much as you can, and you will get a lot coming back to you. If you just stay quiet somewhere in your office or in your home or whatever, nothing happens, but you are fine, you wasted your time. No, this kind of morning and afternoon don't come very often. So you got to chase for what you really want. Ask for the moon if you have to. Chase for the stars. And I tell you, these planets in the morning are powerful enough. These planets are very powerful. There's the Saturn, there's the Mars, there's the Mercury, there's the Uranus. They're all ganged up there with the powerful energy. So it's all up to you to make use of them. Evening nightfall, I don't like. I don't like because they're planets of deception and deceit. You can be made use of. You can be cheated. You can be just a person who did things which with no results, and that'll make you very unhappy towards the end of the evening. You could be with people who drink a lot or do drugs or some nasty, horrible things like that. Avoid these people. They are all losers. And this is a planet of a loser in your horoscope. This is a planet who wants to make you extremely dependent on the bad things of life and dependent on the bad people in life who just make use of you. So if you don't really have to be out, don't. But if you have to be out, make sure you're in the company that you respect. That way the respectfulness will also overflow on you and give you plenty of confidence. It won't make you feel a person who is very low in spirit, very low in feelings. So be very choosy. Be careful of accidents, don't drink too much, stay away from the sea. And most of all, watch out for deceptive and deceitful people. So be sharp. When they flatter you too much, tell them, I'm going to be careful of you. Saturday the 15th, that's a 24 hours of a good luck day. You're going to have a fantastic Saturday, I can see that. Morning, afternoon, you do so well. You're so sharp with your intelligence, with your creativity. People just want to be with you. And so ring up the people. If you're alone, ring up the people you want to be with, and they'll say, yes, we want to be with you, or I want to be with you, something like that. And tell yourself it's going to be a wonderful, progressive, rewarding morning and afternoon period. So be on your best behavior, which means simply do things from others, for others. Tell yourself, I'm going to be supportive, I'm going to be appreciative, and all that will come back to you, loads and loads of good luck. And people will love you as well. Evening, nightfall, long-term planets are there, and I like them and I respect them for people in Capricorn. And these long-term planets, they move slowly, so you got to be patient. Don't expect the evening, nightfall, in half an hour's time, you got what you want. No. Be patient, and hour by hour by hour, these slow planets will help you. These slow planets are usually long-term planets, so they are developing something very slow and steady and nice and progressive and rewarding. So be patient. Don't expect somebody you meet in an early part of the evening and boy, you've got him or her in your arms. No, wait your time and you will see the person will come looking for you because they'll be noticing you as well. So look good, look sharp, dress well, and you're going to get a lot of gain in the evening nightfall period. So I want you to be out and about and focus on what you really want. Is it to be helped in the job? Is it to be helped in the business? Is it to find a new romance, go where the person goes? Or is it just to be making your family and your loved ones and your children very happy? Go for it. It's such a rewarding planet. Two of them. And they'll make you and everybody else very happy. Well, I'm already Skyping. Well, that's the Saturday for you. I'm already Skyping. And I'm charging USD 550 for a 90-minute Skype session. And during this 90 minutes, I'll talk to you about your next 7 or 8 years in all areas of your life. And that's going to be based on your date of birth, your time of birth, and looking at your palms, looking at your face while face reading you as well. And with all that information, I'll help you know your next 7 or 8 years. I'll give you plenty of information, your lucky colors, your lucky lottery numbers. That will be based on your date of birth, time of birth, and looking at your palm. There, those numbers will be there for the rest of your life with you. And you can, every month, compare them with the numbers I'm giving for people in Capricorn and see if they come close together, they jive, you've got to go and buy. And I'll give you your lucky colors and your lucky directions and your lucky gemstones, a lot of information to get you on top of the world and to know your next 7 or 8 years very, very properly. So go to Facebook, go to Skype, send me a message. I'll come back to you as quick as I can and let's get it on for the next 7 or 8 years to make you that winner you want to be. Until then, thank you and good luck.